Well, at that point, Oscar said, get a job. I'm working with Ted Marshall down at the DA's office. We have $87. And I didn't want to live in a yucky neighborhood. And we found the Palms Apartments on Sahara, off of Paradise, in Commercial Center right next door. And I got a job in advertising and publicity at the Riviera Hotel, which was using my skills, the only skills probably one has coming out of a liberal arts program, is your ability perhaps to write and to think a little bit. Loved it. My job was to take all the show people and Variety and all the Hollywood reporter people to the shows at night, and I would come in, there would be two shows, one at 8 and one at around midnight or something. So I'd get in about 2 in the morning, have a normal day, but learned about advertising and how important it is to market. And from there, in 66, right after Caesar's Palace opened, I was recruited to go over there to work for the head of the casino and the president of the hotel, Nate Jacobson and Jerry Zarowitz. There was the triumvirate of Jay Sarno, who the visionary and extremely exciting man, and Jacobson, who was out of Baltimore, an accountant, brilliant in financing, and then Jerry Zarowitz, who had his reputation in the casino world. And so that was an eye-opening experience for quite some time. But I really was feeling, you know, this isn't sad. I mean, this was fun. I had a great time. But it really wasn't beginning to satisfy me. And both of us had decided that we definitely wanted a family. But I wanted to work. I wanted to be out there. I wanted to get a feel of the community. And so I applied for a job with the Department of Labor. It was called the Concentrated Employment Program. And this was 68, 69, somewhere in there. Got the job, went to work at H. and Owen. At that time, the city was entirely segregated. Not partially segregated, entirely. It had been segregated. The only jobs for African Americans were maids and porters. That was it. And so I took the job. It was hooked a little bit with the Economic Opportunity Board, which was David Hogard, Mabel Hogard, and met a great group of people, but worked there in marriage, drug, alcohol, job training, any type of counseling you could possibly do, any type. And the purpose being to get out in the community and try and open the job market for African Americans.